So this lecture is purely an introductory lecture about LaTeX, and a little disclaimer that you might not understand many things in this lecture. But this is my promise that you will understand each and everything in detail when I will explain this in my later lectures. For now, if you don't understand anything, just bear with me. So for any typesetting in LaTeX, any formatting which we want to do in LaTeX, we need three things. First, we need something where we can write our text, plus some commands to typeset that text, to format that text. So for that, we need an editor where we can write some text plus the typesetting commands. And the second thing we need is some program, some packages which can convert that text into a beautiful looking, high quality professional document, a typeset document, a high quality document. So we write in the editor, then we compile here. This set of packages, this collection of packages is called LaTeX distribution, also called LaTeX toolbox. And it has three things in it: compilers, which compile our document, which is a kind of program because it has text plus commands. So this document will have some text which we want to put in our document, plus some commands which will be used to format the document the way we like. So this is the purpose of the LaTeX, to format the document in a professional, beautiful looking document. The distribution has three components. The first is the compiler, which understands these commands and understands what we are trying to say to the program, what type of formatting we want. So these are compilers. And some of the examples of compilers are PDF Textify. This is a compiler. I'm just giving you some names, but we will be explaining this later. So what is PDF Textify? It converts our file, which is a text document, which will have an extension of .tex or text. We will input this file into this compiler and we will get a PDF out of it. So therefore it is called PDF Textify. It converts a text document to PDF. The second thing these packages have, they have some support programs. One example would be BibTeX. And what this does, this puts citations in a research paper or in a book. At the end of the book, you might have seen some citations. So this program puts citation in our document. Then a lot of packages. So what are these packages? These are basically add-ons. So they have some extra functionality, some extra styles, and some extra functions to our document, because LaTeX document can have some functions as well, some interactive functions, some JavaScript, some coding, some macros, and some extra styling, tables of many types, text of many types, some fancy headers, fancy footers, some diagrams, some graphics, so a lot of things. So these packages, they add this extra functionality. We use these packages as and when required basis in our program. And let me tell you the command. We put use package. This is a command which we put in our text file, and we tell our distribution that we are using this package. So our distribution will see if the package is already on our computer. If not, it will install the package from the internet. This distribution will take care of this package. What are our options for this LaTeX distribution? So there are two main options we have. One is called MikTeX and the other is called TechLive. So this is a little comparison between MikTeX and TechLive. So MikTeX is normally by default, when you install MikTeX, it will install some standard packages first. And then when if you use some other package in your program, then it will install that package. It will ask you for permission and it will install you. I will show you this in my next video, how it works. While in TechLive, the standard installation will install all the packages available currently on the internet, which will be around maybe 5 GB. So It depends which type of installation you really want. I would prefer MikTek because I like on-the-fly packages. The second point is that if you have an individual PC, then MikTek is better for you because you are in complete control of your internet, your password, everything. So whenever you like, you can install package, there is no problem. But if you are in a server environment where other people are using it, and maybe your server administrator sometimes is not available, and you need some package, and that package is not available in MikTek, so then it might be a problem. MikTek might not be able to install the package. So in that case, TekLive will be a better solution because you have already all the packages. The third comparison point is this MikTek was developed for Windows from the beginning, from the very beginning. So it has a complete Windows background, no Linux, Unix. So if you are a Windows user, like most, then I will prefer this. And if you use Linux, then you can go for TekLive. Because the good thing about TekLive is that it's a multi-platform. You can switch the platform between Linux and Windows, whatever you like. Now, this point is very important. In TekLive, there is a policy of must freeze policy. After 1 year, they take some time to get the new version of TekLive. So there is a certain break between the old version and the new version. There is a freeze for some time. So what it means is that after that new version, you will have to do the installation again. While in MikTek, the update is not so often. The new version comes, but it depends on when it comes, just like any other software. The last point is slightly more packages for MikTek. I have read somewhere on internet that thesis package is not available in TekLive. You can double check, it might be available now. So these are some of the differences. So these are some of the differences we have between MikTek and TekLive. So you can decide whatever you like, but it doesn't matter. Both will work fine, and any of these editor will work fine. Now coming towards the PDF viewer. So normally we use Adobe Acrobat Reader, but this Sumatra is also a fantastic PDF viewer. Very simple, lightweight, and especially if you are like me, I use WinEdit, and with WinEdit, this is the best choice. And another thing about PDF viewer is that some of these text editors, they have their PDF viewer inside, like this Text Studio. Text Studio has internal PDF viewer, while WinEdit has an external PDF viewer. And what it means is that when you make the PDF, so WinEdit, this is WinEdit, it will open another program, any of these, whichever you have, like Fox, it is another choice. So this is a program where you will compile, it will open another window and it will open your viewer, your PDF Acrobat Reader or whatever you have in this window. While in TekLive, for example, this is your program. So it will make two portions. This is your program, it will open an internal PDF viewer and it will show you the output of your program, your beautiful PDF in itself, inside the Text Studio. So this is another factor of choice when deciding which one you want to use. Another important factor of choice could be the syntax highlighting. And I will explain this later. Question is, if we first have to write our program in editor, then why I am mentioning the distribution first? Because first we have to write a program, then compile it, and then view it. Then why this order? Because this is the order of installation. You must install the LaTeX distribution first, then the editor, then viewer, if you don't have one. Because otherwise, you might have to set some options in your editor, and which at the beginning stage could be difficult for you. So the better thing is just to install the LaTeX distribution first, so that when you install editor, it will fill out all the fields about the path and everything, where it will be finding the bin file, for example, or where is the executable files for PDF viewer, for example, or DVI viewer. So these were some of the basic information which I wanted to tell you, but we will be discussing all this in detail in our next videos.